The last quadric surface we're going to try to sketch is the hyperbolic paraboloid, and it looks like this. Again, notice that it has one term that is degree one and the others are degree two. Kind of looks like the paraboloid. So there's the word paraboloid, but it is hyperbolic, and that's how you distinguish it from the paraboloid. The paraboloid will have plus here in between, so plus, 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 plus. But for a hyperbolic paraboloid, you need to see hyperbola, so we have minuses, okay? So this is a very interesting graph. Yeah, I won't show you all the variations, okay? This, I think, is the most popular version of the hyperbolic paraboloid, which some of you probably know is also called the saddle, okay? So that's our last challenge for the quadric surface, is to try to draw a saddle. Okay, let's just have a simple equation of a hyperbolic paraboloid. So I just made all my constants equal to 1, okay? So I have y squared minus x squared is equal to z. If we look at our traces on the coordinate planes, let's see. Try that. All right, so again, if I cover x, for instance, I'll get y squared is equal to z. One square term and one linear term, that means I have a parabola, right? Okay, vertex at 0, 0. And when y is equal to plus or minus 1, I have z is equal to 1. So let's see that here. So y equals plus or minus 1. I have z is equal to 1. So there's my parabola on the yz. So let me try and color that here. So the green parabola is flat on the yz, okay? So I don't see this, of course, this is in the other room. Okay, so you have that. And then, likewise, if I cover the y, I have negative x squared equals z. Negative x squared equals z, again, that's degree 2, degree 1, so I know this is going to be a parabola. Vertex at 0, 0, but notice there's a minus there. So if I replace x by plus or minus 1, positive or negative 1, I'll get z is equal to negative 1. So let's see what's happening. This is my x-axis. If I let x be plus or minus 1 in the back, okay, my z will have to be here, right? 1, negative 1 rather, for both the case x is 1 or x equals negative 1. Okay, so that's on the other side of the whiteboard. Okay, so let me use blue for that trace. And I have that other one over there. Okay, and of course, later on we can be brave and just extend these guys. Okay, now if I want the trace on the xy plane, so that means I make this equal to 0. So I get, let me do that. So on the xy plane, I have y squared minus x squared is 0, or that will give me y equals plus or minus x. So on the xy plane, I really just hit two lines, right? Two lines intersecting at the origin. So let's say when x is 1, y is 1. So I'll have this line, and there's something in the back. And then I have another line here, and there's something there, okay? So really what we have now are the three sets of traces, right? The green, let's see, do I remember what the green is? The green is flat on the whiteboard, right? That's the yz trace, which is the parabola y squared equals z. And then I have the xz trace going sideways, the blue parabola, which is negative x squared equals z. And then I have these two lines on the floor, right? Y equals plus or minus x. So that doesn't really give me any idea what the graph will look like right now, okay? So this is where we really need to look at our cross sections, okay? So we want to see what will happen, let's say, as we move up on the z-axis, okay? So let's say we move up on the z-axis, so that means to say I replace my z by k, all right? Y squared minus x squared equals k. And we have to break this into two cases. The first case being, let's say I make my k bigger than 0. That means I'm going up here, all right? So what happens is, again, you look at this form and you recognize that these are nothing but hyperbolas, okay? With axes or vertices sitting kind of on the y-axis. So This will be hyperbolas, whose vertices will be somewhere here on the Y. So this is the degenerate form of the hyperbola, actually, that we got earlier, the two lines, right? But as you keep moving up, what this is saying is, maybe I can use black, you will have a hyperbola that goes like this, and then there's something in the back, goes like this, something in the back. So forward and back, right? So these hyperbolas will be parallel to the XY plane, okay? And notice your vertices are kind of like on the Y-axis, right? On the lines that are parallel to the Y-axis. So you keep doing this, and then of course, because K becomes big, then these hyperbolas will just get wider and wider like that, okay? So you'll have something like this. So there you go, your saddle is forming in front, I mean, going sideways like that. All right, so that's what will happen when you have this K greater than zero, okay? So these hyperbolas that go sideways, they're what you will produce. Now we can also look at the case of what happens when we substitute values of K or Z, right, that are negative. So we're looking at what happens when we go down the Z-axis. Now when this is negative, okay, let me just give you an example. Let's say you have Y squared minus X squared equals negative 1. So we know that in order to recognize this, we have to make that a 1. So the roles of X and Y will be interchanged. So you'll have X squared minus Y squared is equal to 1. So, but again, you notice that this will be, because these are both squares and that's a minus sign and that's a 1, that this will be hyperbolas as well, right? And the K will become bigger and bigger, so the hyperbolas will kind of become wider and wider as you move right down, okay? So let's see how we will illustrate that. So the X being positive, that means to say that your vertex will be on the X, okay? And now the Y will just determine how wide it opens. So that's why you have going to have kind of a hyperbola that opens that way towards us, like this, okay? Parabola, hyperbola that opens like that. And then in the back, the hyperbola will open to the back like that. Like, you see it? So something like that. All right. So at this point, I become brave and I just start connecting, okay, this. And I say, all right, there's my saddle. I connect this to this. I connect this to this, okay? And then I drew, did I draw it? I drew this hyperbola over on this side, right? And I draw this there. Okay, sorry, that you do not see that. So let's make that broken, okay? And then this is the branch of the hyperbola. I kind of like, I'm cheating here now in the back, okay? You can't see anyway. So there you have it. And then you connect, and there's your saddle. So this is how you draw your hyperbolic paraboloid, a rough sketch of it, okay? So notice your traces. And yeah, hopefully that looks like a saddle. I don't have it handy right now, but if you have a Pringle is an example of a hyperbolic paraboloid. So try to grab a Pringle and see if you can find those traces, the parabolas, one opening flat and the other opening sideways, okay? And the hyperbolas, one, some opening this way sideways and some opening front and back. Okay, so that's your hyperbolic paraboloid.
Okay, you're done.